Good evening, everyone. I'd like to welcome you to part one of our end of year concert series featuring the jazz band and our wonderful string orchestra. My name is Grant Knox, and I'm the humble and proud director of this band and orchestra program here at Cienega High School. It's my privilege to share with you part one of our end of year concert, which is going to feature a wide array of popular charts, jazz charts, classical orchestra repertoire, and much, much more. Tonight's event is being live streamed by Mr. Nick Irvin, his Bobcat TV team. And so in order to provide a distraction-free concert experience for everyone in the audience as well as at home, we ask that you take this moment to please silence all cell phones, place them on airplane mode, or even better, turn them off and enjoy this wonderful music that's about to be made. Lastly, I'd like to take a moment to recognize a few entities in their support in making this concert happen. First and foremost, Mrs. Middleton, Mrs. Kim Middleton, our principal, and Mrs. Brenna Torres, our assistant principal of Fine Arts, and the rest of the wonderful administration team for their continued support of the Fine Arts program. If we could please give them a round of applause. Next up, Mr. Jeremy Vega, Ms. Jessica Armistead, and Ms. Ruth Latona, as my wonderful Fine Arts counterparts and colleagues. And then there's their entire support of our band and orchestra program. And then lastly, all of you wonderful parents, guardians, siblings for putting up with many hours, countless hours of practice, annoying out-of-tune sounds as they're trying to better themselves, and then just the transportation, all of the many ways that you guys support. And so greatly appreciate the ways that you guys value music education in these young students' lives, and so you all deserve a round of applause as well. So tonight's event is going to be super special in that we have a number of students who have kind of forged leadership positions within our concert ensembles and taking control of the artistic direction of this program. So hopefully this will mean limited talking from me, and you'll get to hear some of the creative sides of these wonderful students. But first, I'd like to start off with kind of a recap of our string orchestra and the wonderful year that they've had as we're coming to the end of this 21-22 school year. So just want to recap a few great things that have been done. So first and foremost, we've experienced a lot with some solo and chamber music. If you haven't gotten the chance yet, you can check out our wonderful Bobcat TV YouTube channel and our fall concert. You guys will hear from our wonderful cello quartet as well as a solo. You guys will get to hear more solo performance tonight. Next, this has been a very unique group to work with in the idea of it being kind of half and half balance of freshmen and largely juniors and seniors. There is not a, correct me if I'm wrong, is there a sophomore in the group? Do we have a sophomore? Okay, so we have one sophomore who just happens to not be here. it has been quite the experience, the fun experience of this orchestra has really kind of rediscovered the family sense in that it feels like a giant family, and they fight that way too in class. You should see them. But it's all fun and for the love of music and the betterment of each other. So it's just been a fun year that way. We've attended a couple of festivals in the fall. We attended the Aboa Fall Orchestra Festival at Tucson High School, where this group earned an excellent rating, performing some repertoire that kind of was a wake-up call, a welcome to high school call for many of our freshman members. But nonetheless, they embraced it and took it head-on, worked their butts off, and received a similar rating at the Spring Festival at Catalina Foothills just last month. So really great work done on the assessment front. We've had a lot of fun preparing music all year, and it's great that they got good feedback and were rewarded for the fruits of their labor all year. So if we could please give them a round of applause for that. And the very last thing, I'd like to take a moment to recognize all of our senior members and senior and graduating members. By name, and so first we have Isabel Ross, which you'll hear from her in a second, is our concert master. Lazaria Woodson, Juan Aponte, Luma Van Horn, Brianna Harris, and Sammy Castro. So, yeah. So as I mentioned before, we're very fortunate to have such great leadership at the top of our ensemble, upperclassmen who are not just responsible of their own parts, but willing to kind of take our younger members of the orchestra under their wings and really make them feel warm and welcome. And that's what kind of separates Cienega's fine arts programs from the rest in this family environment that we create. So without further ado, I present to you our string orchestra.
Thank you.
jazz. So I'm going to pass it off to Mr. David Chase, and he's going to tell you more about it.
Thank you. So firstly, I'd like to thank Mr. Knox for allowing me to start this ensemble and for encouraging us to really bring our ideas to life. So can we get a round of applause for Mr. Knox real quick? Alright, so as we've been setting up, I do want to share sort of how this band came to be, my thought process setting all of this up. So when creating this band, I'm sitting there one night, and I'm thinking about all the directors that I've been under in the past, right? And I decided to combine each aspect that I found very significant that I learned from them, right? So the big band setup from that I learned from Mr. Matsushino, the idea of non-traditional instruments and the kind of energy from Mr. Knox, and the sense of groove and rhythm that I learned from Mr. Constantine, my middle school director. So, then once I combined those, sent out a Google form, thinking I was only going to get maybe 9 or 10 responses back. I got 28 responses back, all excited to play a big band chart. So, once I got that all established, we did rehearsals. This group has given so much time and energy to rehearse and prepare for this performance, right, out of just their own time, right? So, I'm incredibly proud of this group. It means a lot to me, it's very important to me. So, without further ado, I present the Cienega High School Little Big Band playing Sir Duke by Stevie Wonder. recognize our soloist, Haley Nielsen, on tenor sax. And Dayla Jernan on the drums. Awesome performance, guys. I'm really proud of you.
Jazz is just one of the many dialects that we can speak in. And so part of the early periods of the semester or for the year for this group include learning the beautiful and eclectic idiom of jazz. But nonetheless, this group has faced some awesome successes. So last month, they also had the privilege of going to assessment. This was held at the University of Arizona during the first week of spring break. And this wonderful group received a superior with distinction rating. So that means that's the highest grade that you can get as an ensemble, and that means all three or four of your judges were unanimously voted for you to receive a superior grade. So if we could give them a round of applause. So we kind of changed the name this year to the Jazz Lab Band, as this group has undergone some experimental stuff, so including some instruments that aren't traditionally in the big band. You'll see clarinet, you'll see bass clarinet, as well as some other instruments here and there. At the beginning of the year, we had a violin, and that was a lot of fun. And so it's been a really cool experimental process, and this last quarter, this fourth quarter, has really kind of encapsulated all of those experiments into one awesome experience. And so I'm excited to bring on each of these seniors to tell you more about this process. But first, I'd like to recognize all of our seniors. So first, we have Mr. David Chase, Mr. Dalen Duren, Mr. Ryan Suhe, and Mr. Graham Miller. If we could please give them a round of applause. So first, you're going to get to hear from Mr. Brigger Miller. He's going to tell you a little bit about some Count Basie and this exciting experiment project that we got to undergo.
Hi. Thank you very much for coming out tonight. So I was chosen to be an artistic director for tonight's show. And basically what that means is I basically took over class for part of the day, and I was able to teach one song that I chose for a few hours every day. And the piece I chose is called Meetin' Time by Count Basie. And what's interesting about what we did here is we didn't actually have any music for this chart. So what we did was we listened to it, and we actually had to write down all of our individual parts, and you'll kind of hear that in our music tonight. So, without further ado, this is Meetin' Time.
Thank you.
Hi, it's me again. All right, so the next piece that we're playing is If I Ain't Got You by Alicia Keys. All right, the song means a lot to me. All right, so it's really cool that we get to play our own rendition of this. All right, so. Jesse, take it away. Thank you.
Hello?
Ah, it works. So, my song is So What and Black and Blues. That is compositions by Miles Davis and Al Jarreau. I was in the middle of arranging So What, and the thought struck me that it's in a decent key that's close to it, so we might as well try it, and I think it turned out pretty well. I would also like to thank, and I think he's been mentioned before tonight, Christopher Constantine, for coming into my English class in seventh grade and saying, hey, you know what, you play guitar, you should try jazz band. And I can wholeheartedly say, because of the efforts of band teachers, I made it into the U of A studying jazz studies, and I made it as the all-state drummer.
All right, so we have one last set change as we're going to invite our awesome string orchestra back out for kind of a big grand finale. But before I do that, I'd like to sincerely thank you all for joining us for part one of this interview concert cycle. I have thoroughly enjoyed watching these young artists be their best selves and express themselves so creatively and share that with their peers. So if we can give our student leaders a small round of applause. Again, that was Mr. Brian Miller. Mr. David Chase. And Mr. Dalen Durbin. I'd like to also take a moment to thank a few other people who helped make this happen. First is our wonderful new accompanist. She spends most of her workday with Mr. Vega and our awesome choir program, but she was so gracious enough to share her time and her talents with us, and that's Ms. Chantel Funkins. We can please give her a round of applause. I'd like to also thank the awesome students and staff members of the Vail Theatre for preparing this concert hall for us. Any requests that we had, they were happy to oblige so that these students could be their best selves. And I greatly appreciate them opening up this hall for us and making it such an awesome, pleasant concert experience. Would you please give them a round of applause? And then lastly, I could thank him at every event, and it will never be enough. Mr. Nick Irvin for the incredible work that he does with Bobcat TV. We have so much fun the day after concerts, watching back our concert and seeing each time the high quality production. Every time it gets better, and he is just always so happy to share. Each time I'll panic and send him an email and give him all the details and such, and he just sends me, yeah, we're good, thanks for inviting me, and I will be there, and I'm like, you are the man. So if we could please give Mr. Nick Irvin a round of applause. So we'll be back here a week from today for the second installment, if you will, of our concert series, end of year concert series, featuring the concert band as well as the symphonic band. But until then, I invite you all to stay tuned with the latest updates of our program via social media, our Facebook and Instagram pages, as well as on our website. On those pages, you will see information for, once again, RSVPing for our year in review screening at the Galaxy Theater. That's next Tuesday, May 3rd. At 6:30 p.m., as well as our end-of-year banquet at Cienega High School in the Student Union, also at 6:30 p.m. on Friday, May 6th. So I'd love to see you all out there so that we can celebrate these young musicians one last time. So before we end, I'd like to once again thank you all for attending, and without further ado, this is Marvin Gaye's What's Going On. soloist, David Chase. Armand Dion. Sam Constantine. Mr. Perry Miller. Recognize our wonderful rhythm section. String Orchestra. And our jazz. Again, thank you all so much. I had so much fun making music with these musicians. And we'll see you again next week. Thank you all. Drive safely.